Very good morning, students. For this lecturing video session, I have come up with one more problem from the topic cycloid, right? In the last video, I taught you the construction of cycloid, isn't it? Right. So here I have come up with another problem from the topic cycloid. Let me just read out the question, right, to make you understand. A thin circular disc. As I told you in the previous lecturing video, the object could be in circular form, right? Either it could be thin coin or drum or any circular disc or cylinder, isn't it? Right. A thin circular disc of 50 mm diameter. So the given data, so the dia equal to 50 mm. Therefore, the radius of the particular disc could be d by 2, which is 50 by 2, 25 mm, isn't it? Yeah, radius is half of the diameter, right? Is allowed to roll without slipping from upper edge of sloping plane, which is inclined 15 degree with the horizontal plane. Draw the curve traced by the point on the circumference of the disc. In the previous problem, the object was in this manner. It is allowed to roll on the horizontal surface, isn't it? This rolling circle starts rolling over the horizontal plane, and when it comes here, it would have traced the curve in this manner, right? Here, the question is slightly different from the normal one, right? Here, it starts rolling without slipping from the upper edge of sloping plane, which is inclined at 15 degree with the horizontal, right? That means, suppose this is the horizontal one, right? The upper edge of the sloping plane is 15 degree. That means this is 15 degree. Now this is the platform on which this rolling circle starts rotating. Rotating from where? Slipping from upper edge. That means from here. From here, it starts rotating in this direction and it reaches somewhere here and it generates this kind of path. This is what I am going to construct here, right? So, first what I am going to do is choose a point and draw a thin line. So, keep your protractor in this manner. Keep your protractor in this manner. Take 15 degree. Take 15 degree and extend this line. And extend this line. Right. So, what I am going to, going to draw a little lower. So that I could get a clear view. So this is a point 15 degree. So it is a 15 degree, right? So one complete revolution, that means how much length it would have been rolled. Yeah, for circular object, the circumference length of the circle is pi d. Pi is 3.14, the diameter is 50, so which it works out to 157 mm, which works out to 157 mm. Now, what I am going to do is, taking the extreme point, from here, 157 I am going to mark. This is my 157, right? From here, I have taken 157, right? Now, keep your protractor in this manner. Keep your protractor in this manner. Choose 90 degree. Choose 90 degree and draw a line. Extend this line. It's a thin line. So draw a line. Now this is perpendicular. That is making 90 degree. What is the radius of this particular rolling circle? Is 25 mm. Isn't it? So now from here take 25 mm. This is my 25 mm. Right. Now this is the center of the rolling circle. This is the center of the rolling circle or the generating circle. Now take 25 mm compass and see as center and see as center. Go for a full circle. Go for a full circle. Go for a full circle. See as center. See as center. Draw a full circle of radius 25 mm. Of radius 25 mm. Right. So now what we did in the previous problem, we used to divide the rolling circle into 8 equal parts. Similarly the baseline also I have divided into 8 equal parts. Right. Now keeping the protractor here, choose 90 degree, draw a line. Right. Now this particular rolling circle, that means the circular object, has been split into 4 equal parts. Now I need to split into 8 equal parts. Now keep your protractor in this manner. Keep your protractor in this manner. Choose 45 degree. Similarly this side also 45 degree. Now the chosen point, draw a line from the chosen point passing through the point C. Right. Similarly here also chosen point, that is 45 degree, passing through the center. Now I have split or even made the division of 8 equal parts of the rolling circle. Fine. Now let me just give the naming for it. See, as far as point 8 is concerned, where there is a contact, where there is a contact of rolling circle and the baseline is named as 8. See, in this condition this rolling circle is rotating in anti-clockwise direction, because from the upper edge the sloping point, which is inclined 15 degree, from there it starts rolling over. Right. From upper edge to lower edge it starts rolling, therefore it is rotating in the counterclockwise or anti-clockwise direction. So the dimension, sorry, the numbering should be opposite to it. Right. So numbering should be in clockwise manner. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and 8. Next, what you have to draw a perpendicular line to this baseline. A very thin line, perpendicular line. So this distance between 8 and this extreme point is the circumference length of the circle, which is 157 mm. Now draw a line parallel to the baseline or the directory line or the straight line. So passing through 5 and 3, that means from 4 I am going to draw a parallel line to the base in this manner. Similarly 5 and 3, passing through 5 and 3, passing through 5 and 3, 6 and 2, now passing through 1 and 7, passing through 1 and 7, passing through 1 and 7, right. So this is the distance where the rolling circle completes one revolution or one convolution. Now I need to split this particular division into 8 equal part. So what I have to do? So keep compass at 8 and take more than half of the circumference length, and keeping at 8 cut an arc above and below. Similarly change, now the change the center as the extreme point here, without changing the radius, cut above and below and connect this. Now this particular portion has been divided into 2 equal division. Right. Now I need to split this into 8. Totally I have divided this into 2. Now I have further I have to divide into 6 more, right? So divide this into 2. So let me just change this. So this is the halfway. So this is the center where it has been bifurcated into 2. Now within this I have to make 4 division, for which this is the only extreme portion and this is one more extreme portion. So take more than half, because the method which I am using here is the bisecting method, right? Take more than half, cut an arc here and arc here. Now this is extreme portion, cut an arc here, cut an arc here, connect this line, right? Now taking this as 2 extreme points, from here the compass, take more than half and cut an arc here, cut an arc here. Keep one lug of the compass at this position, cut an arc, cut an arc, right? The same thing I am going to repeat here. Take more than half, because this is the 2 extreme points. So stretch more than half and cut an arc above as well as below. Now change the position of the compass at 8, cut an arc here, cut an arc here, right? So this particular 1, 2, 3, 4 parts have been divided. Now for this portion, comes to this portion, these are the 2 extreme, right? Keeping the compass here, take more than half, cut an arc above as well as below. Now change the center here without changing the radius, above and below, right? Now these are the 2 extremes. So keeping a compass here, take more than half, cut an arc above as well as below. Now keep your compass here without changing the radius, cut above and below. Similarly, this portion, these are the 2 extreme points. Keeping a compass here, take more than half of this distance, cut above as well as below. Now keep your compass at this extreme point, above and below. Now connect this. So now look at here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and 8 division has been made here. Now extend till this center of the this particular rolling circle, I extend it. Now let me just give the naming for it. Since I have given 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 for the rolling circle, here I am going to give the naming for this baseline as 1 dash, 2 dash, 3 dash, 4 dash, 5 dash, 6 dash, 7 dash and 8 dash, right? Similarly for the center, this as C, therefore this could be C1 and this could be C2, this could be C3, C4, C5, C6, C7 and C8. Look at here the corresponding baseline division, here it is 8, therefore here it is C8, here it is 7 and here it is 7, right? The center point has been marked here. What is next? So as being the cycloid, here the center varies and your radius doesn't vary. Radius is constant. What is the radius of the rolling circle? 25 mm. Take 25 mm in your compass, keeping C as center, cut an arc. It exactly cuts at point number 8. So this could be P. Now change the center as at C1. Now cut an arc on 1, the line 1. Where exactly the line? Yeah, here it is. So therefore it cuts somewhere here. So this point could be P1. Right? Now change the center, C2, without changing the radius, right? Without changing the radius, cut an arc. So where exactly the 2 is? Yeah, here, somewhere here. This could be P2. The P1 is here, P2 is somewhere here. Now change the position, that is C3, cut an arc on line 3. So it cuts somewhere here. So this could be P3. Now change the center that is C4, without changing the radius, cut an arc at the line 4. Line 4 is here, it will cut an arc on this line. Fine. Now change the center. Now C5 as center, cut an arc on line 5. So line 5 is somewhere here. So this could be point 5. Now C6 as center, cut an arc on line 6, where the line 6 is here. Yeah, line 6 is somewhere here. So this could be P6. Now change the center. C7 as center, cut an arc on line 7. Where is line 7? The line 7 is here. This could be P7. And C8 as center, cut an arc on line 8. Line 8 is here. It could intersect here. This could be P8. I have marked all the points. Now what I am going to do is plotting all the points which I marked on this diagram. So from P to P1, P1 to P2, P2 to P3, P3 to P4, P4 to P5, P5 to P6, P6 to P7, and P8. Once you are confident enough that, I mean, the curve which you have drawn is smooth and perfect, then switch over the pencil, that means from 2H to HR, HB, by a smooth curve over the 2H curve which you have drawn. Right? This curve is nothing but the cycloid. Right? I have constructed the curve, the profile, that is cycloid. What is next? Now I need to mark the dimension. Right? What I have to, so I have to specify the inclination here. So this could be 15 degree with a horizontal. So this platform is 15 degree. Now the diameter of this particular circle, that is a rolling circle, is 50 mm. So which can be mentioned as, so mentioning these two extreme points, 3 and 7, draw a leader line and dia 50. This pi symbol denotes circle, that is diameter, right? Dia 50. Now what is next? Which is the circumference length of the particular rolling circle, right? So draw a line perpendicular to the base, right? Extend it. Similarly, from 8, extend it. Now draw a line which is parallel to the baseline, arrowhead to be filled, the ratio should be 1:3, and this should be 157, so this is nothing but the baseline R, directing line. Baseline or directing line. And what about this circle? This circle is nothing but rolling circle or the generating circle. I have marked the dimensions here. So whatever is given, 50, I have marked here. And the circumference length I have marked. And the inclination with respect to the horizontal plane as 15 degree, I covered everything. Now, I need to specify or to mark the tangent and normal for this. Though it is not specified or not been asked here, it's our duty to draw the tangent and normal. I'm going to choose any point on the circle. Now, I'm going to choose somewhere here. This point is 1. Let me just take this point as 1. What is the radius of the rolling circle? Which is 25 mm. Take 25 mm in your compass. Keeping at 1, cut an arc on the center. Number 2. Now if you want, you just even connect this line, thin line. Right. Now I need to draw a perpendicular line corresponding with baseline. Extend it. Now this is point number 3. What is next? I am going to connect point 1 and 3. 1 and 3. This is nothing but the normal n n dash. What about tangent? Tangent should be 90 degree or right angle with the normal. Keep your protractor in this manner. Choose 90 degree and draw a line which is nothing but your tangent tt dash. This should be 90 degree. Though it is not specified in the question, but to complete a profile or a drawing, one must to present everything, that is curve, tangent and normal. Fine. Now I'll have to give the notes of it. So what exactly it is? So the note is n n dash stands for what? N n dash stands for normal, right? Then the guideline should be 5 mm gap, right? So next tt dash, which refers tangent, which represent tangent, right? Next, the dimension which you have considered here, I have considered the dimension in mm, therefore the unit of the dimension should be specified here. All dimensions are in mm. All dimensions are in mm. Since I haven't changed any of the dimensions, whether I increased or decreased of the given diameter, as it is I have taken, therefore it is a actual dimension, therefore it is a the scale which I consider is a true scale, which can be mentioned as scale 1:1. Then what about this curve or the profile? If you want, you can just mention by drawing the guideline mentioning the curve is a the curve is a cycloid. OID. Fine. Check before you proceed to other diagram whether you have covered everything or not. First check the profile is finished or not. Next dimensioning, next tangent and normal, everything finished. Next comes to the note with the dimensioning, scale and the profile name, right? Remember, only 3 things should be drawn as dark: the profile, which is nothing but the curve, the normal and the tangent. Thank you.